Today we are going to interview City of Vincent Mayor Emma Cole. So we are asking about the Beaufort Strait business closure. In Beaufort Strait, so many businesses are closing, and we can ask about the mayor what happening and what they are bringing the changes for the people.
Yes, we have seen some iconic businesses close in Beaufort Strait, but it's not all bad news. There's lots of positive things happening on Beaufort Strait too. We have seen closures of venues like Clarence's and Five Bar and Empire Homewares, which has caused quite a bit of shock in our community. But we're also seeing new businesses join the street and some new developments coming on stream as well. So that's a really great sign of confidence in Beaufort Street. And we've also seen the beautiful heritage building, the Alexander Building, which is on the corner of Walcott and Beaufort Street, have an approval for obviously retaining that beautiful heritage frontage but doing a whole redevelopment at the back. So really great signs of confidence on Beaufort Street. We did have Pipes for Perth there for a time, which is always a bit tricky for businesses. They are now moved on, so they're no longer there. They've finished replacing those 100-year-old pipes and they have moved on. And I think the benefit with those works is that they did actually do them very quickly. They knew that there were issues, and they also had the issue of having high frequency buses trying to get up Beaufort Street. So those works were really sped up to get that work done, and they've now moved on. So a bit of pain, but that's now finished and the street is free from that now. But the city's also doing a lot of work on Beaufort Street. We're about to embark on a vacancy project. So at the moment we do have some pretty difficult economic situation in Perth and in WA and more broadly in Australia, where we are seeing shop closures. But we think that if we can work with landlords to get some short-term tenants in to those spaces, hopefully at reduced rents because they'd be pop-up, then that would really bring some life to the street and actually fill those vacancies. We've also got a series of actions planned around lighting the street with some really nice ambient lighting. We're bringing events to the street. We've got funding to do that. And we're working really closely with our partners, Beaufort Street Network, which is the local town team, and talking to lots of people that we regularly hold events with to see whether they would like to bring their event to Beaufort Street.
What do you think this type of closure of business bring any bad impact on the Beaufort Street also?
Well, look, there's so many factors at play. I know that people have been talking about rents. My focus is on what the City of Vincent can do and how we can play our part. So lots of different factors. The economy is pretty tough. Lower consumer spending. People are not sort of out and about in this area, but we think through things like filling the shop fronts, getting people living on the street, working on the street. We're also having a 12-month amnesty on change of use applications on the street. So normally if a business wants to start up and they're going into a shop front that might be an office, they then have to go through a process to change that, whether it be a cafe, a small bar, a meeting place, whatever it's going to be. So we're basically saying for 12 months, just move in, set up, don't worry about the paperwork and the planning applications, and we'll support you through that if you want to stay on 12 months down the track. So there's a lot of forces at play and everyone has a role to play, whether you're a landlord, whether you're a local government like us. We can all play our part, and City of Vincent's looking at what we can do, and we've got a package of things that we are doing to help Beaufort Street. It's difficult to know because things change and evolve all the time, and Perth is growing and changing. We've got big box shopping centres coming on stream. We've got Elizabeth Quay, Yagan Square. There's a lot of competition out there, so whether it's the same or whether it's an evolved version, I think Beaufort Street will definitely come back. It's an amazing part of the world, huge potential there for people to come back and really engage in that. And it must be said also that there are some fantastic businesses on Beaufort Street that continue to do really, really well.
In future, we hope so that Beaufort Street will become the same as it was before. It's me, Talha Javed, Undercurrent, WTV, Perth.